Hi, I'm Caroline Rothstein, and this is Body Empowerment. For this episode, I want to talk about how to have a healthy dialogue about the body. In general, I've found that talking about feelings with regard to the body is far more healthy and effective and empowering than using aesthetic descriptors like adjectives or numbers. I made a decision many, many years ago when I began publicly sharing my story about having and recovering from an eating disorder to refrain from using numbers and sizes to describe my body. So for example, when I am sharing about how my body size and shape shifted while I had an eating disorder and even since I've been recovered, I do not share the different weights I was at or the different clothing sizes I had. I think it's really important to not use those numbers because they are an opportunity for us to compare with each other, and that can be triggering. A trigger is something that can cause us to have a visceral reaction to a previously experienced trauma. So for example, when I had an eating disorder, if I was ever presented with numbers, both about my own body and other people's bodies, it could cause me to directly and immediately engage with eating disorder behaviors and symptoms, because it could cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of shame, and a lot of fear. Now, when I think about my body, I only think about how it feels. Another thing that can be really damaging and triggering with regards to talking about the body are descriptors, adjectives. For example, we use things like fat, chubby, overweight, skinny, emaciated, all these descriptors that are totally abstract. They don't really mean anything because they are not offering a basis of comparison. Fat to what? Skinny to what? For whom? None of those words actually tell us what our body is experiencing. They are not feelings. Sadly, we also use terms like anorexic and bulimic as adjectives and descriptors for people's body shapes and sizes. Anorexic and bulimic are clinical terms to describe the mental illness that is an eating disorder. Those also don't accurately or kindly describe our bodies. They are not what our bodies are. They are clinical terms for diseases. My hope is that we can start to have a healthier and kinder dialogue about and around and with our bodies, focusing on feelings and experiences rather than weight, number, size, and adjective descriptors that, again, don't really mean anything. Thank you so much for tuning in to today's Body Empowerment episode. Please subscribe to my channel, Caroline Rothstein TV, and you can find me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, as well as my website, all listed below. Thank you so much, and have a great day.